Hi, Deb Purvin here. Welcome to another Tuesday Tweak. Today, especially because it's the beginning of the year, we're going to talk with you about your buyer's behaviors. Behaviors are changing. They have been changing. Have you noticed a change? And how about your behaviors? How are you making your buying decisions? Now, obviously, these changes are due to COVID, due to the recession, due to inflation, due to all the things that have happened over the last couple of years. And we know with COVID, we expected more purchases to be done online. But the thing that's happened is a lot of the buyers, a lot of the decision makers, 70% of B2B decision makers prefer these remote interactions. And so though we expected it to go back to more in-person decision making and meetings, it has not. And the thing that's even more surprising is that these decisions are being made on purchases of more than $50,000. So it used to be just those small purchases, but now they're actually looking at larger services and products. So the question to you is, your internet, your website, your social media, your content management, is all of that developed? Has it been developed? Has it been modified and reviewed to see if you're getting the most out of these remote interactions where you don't even know who's looking and talking and thinking about calling your company and using your services or your products? So make sure that you're up to date on all of those places that touch your prospect base. Secondly, when closing a sale, you know, marketing used to be on the internet, and then we would get to the salespeople. We would get a lead. Now, obviously, marketing is larger. We know that. But we used to always turn over our sales to the salesperson. That used to be done in person. But now, your sales team has to be able to build trust and sell virtually. More and more of these sales are being done online. And have you trained your salespeople to be able to build trust, to build confidence, to have good communication skills on the internet? And that's a talent, and it takes practice, and it takes some good counseling and coaching. And finally, the third thing that's changing is obviously we know about the Great Resignation, 47 million job resignations last year. And this obviously impacts your key customer relationships. Those have been broken. If your customer service person leaves, your salesperson leaves, all of these folks in a competing company who have left are now, those clients are like, who do I talk to? That is a great opportunity for you to jump in. Jump into your competitor slots. So are you capitalizing on these opportunities? So even though you may have a prospect that's been handled by a customer by a competitor for a really long time, this is a great opportunity to start calling on them again and talking with your prospects. During a recession, most companies look inward. They're worried about making payroll, protecting themselves and their financial resources. Can they make their debt service payments? So they're worried about the reduction in sales and they're not talking to their clients. So this is a great time to be out and looking for new business. And finally, are you protecting the client base that you have? So not only should you be out looking, but that virtual sales call that you're having, keep touching base with your clients. Keep up your content management. Keep providing your clients with good information so they stay your clients and aren't interested in talking to one of your competitors. So quick ad. This is a business model discussion. And if you like the kinds of issues that we talk about in the Tuesday Tweaks, I'd love to have you consider joining my mastermind. We do business models. We talk about best practices. I look at your financials with you every month for a year. So there's a lot of benefit to that. You're in a small peer group. And my next mastermind starts on Monday. So if you're interested in just seeing what it looks like, you can join us Monday. Just email me and I'll send you the link. Finally, if you have any comments or questions, I'd love to talk to you about your buyer's behaviors. Otherwise, I'll see you next week.